Hello everyone, in this video you will learn about supporting structure of the mandible. Supporting structure are the primary supporting structure are also called the primary stage bearing area or the secondary supporting structure or secondary stage bearing area. Primary stage bearing area, the mandible are the buccal shelf area and the retromolar pads. While the secondary stress bearing area is the alveolar ridge. Primary supporting area. Area that are most capable to take the masticated load, providing a proper support to the denture are the primary supporting area. What are the different properties for the primary stress bearing area? Number one is the presence of particle bone. Overlying mucosa could be a while cartonized and firmly attached to underlying periosteum and direction of masticatory forces. It means where those areas where the masticatory forces are directed vertically means right angle, those areas provide the primary support to the prosthesis. Anatomy of the supporting structure, especially the crest of the residual ridge, where the mucous membrane is covered by the keratinized layer of the attached, which is attached to the periosteum by means of some mucosa. Underlying bone is cancellous bone. The crest of the residual ridge may not be favorable as in a primary stitch bearing area for the mandibular danger. Slopes of the residual ridge. Here, there is a thin plate of cortical bone. The slopes or walls are steep and at acute angle to occlusal force and are the second stress bearing area. Buccal shelf is the area between the mandibular buccal plenum and anterior edge of the masseter muscle called the buccal shelf area. This is the buccal shelf area. Bilaterally, this is a primary supporting structure or primary stress bearing area for the mandibular denture. The boundary of this buccal shelf area, it is bounded medially by means of crest of the residual ridge, anteriorly by means of the buccal plenum, laterally by means of external oblique ridge, distally by means of this retromolar pad. Mucous membrane is more loosely attached and less keratinized than that covering the residual ridge, while the bone of the buccal shelf area is covered by a layer of cortical bone. Buccal shelf is in a very wide area and is set at right angle to the vertical force of the occlusion. Due to this reason, it offers excellent resistance to such forces and is more suitable primary stress bearing area of the mandibular arch. Retromolar pad is a triangular soft pad of the tissues. Here the mucosa is composed of thin non-keratinized epithelium. It contains glandular tissues, fibers of the buccinator and superior constructor muscles of pharynx, pterygomandibular raphe and fiber of temporalis muscles. Underlying bone is cortical bone. The denture base should extend to 1/2 to 2/3 of the retromolar pad. So this triangular pad found most distal part of the residual ridge here that provide the primary support to the bone because of presence of underlying cortical bone in the direction of the . So this is the retromolar pad. You can see clinically in the patient mouth, and this is on the diagnostic cast. Myelohyoid ridge. This bony ridge which is found on the lingual side of the mandible. Anteriorly it is lie close to the inferior part of the mandible, while posteriorly after resorption it lies flush to the superior surface of the residual ridge. If you found If my hair is short or regular, it will be easily traumatized and it is required a relief in the denture. Mental phenomena which lie on the external surface of at the premolar region and should be relieved, especially in case it lie close to the residual ridge due to ridge resorption to prevent from the birth. So this mental phenomenon where the mental nerve which has come out, especially those patients who have atrophic ridges, this phenomenon is very near to the crest of the ridge. If you record an impression without any relief, and if you made a denture without relief, the denture will press and compress the nerve. There will be paresthesia of your lip. So that require a relief in the denture. Genial tubercle. Are the dense particle prominence? This tubercle at the inferior border of the mandible at the lingual midline. Tubercle. It's next. Cortical, dense cortical bony prominence. With the resorption, become more prominent and require that leave, especially on the lingual side. And those patients have an atrophic disease, become more prominent and require the relief. Torus mandibularis. It is located in the region of the premolar bilaterally on the lingual side and is covered by a thin mucous membrane which may be irritated by the denture and must be relieved. You found this torus, which is large in size, have undercut and prepared with the extension of the denture. Then it requires surgically to remove the lodged torus. Otherwise, you need to relieve, especially at the area of the torus. The average available denture bearing area for the edentulous mandible is 14 cm². Thanks for watching this video.